Okay, so at this year's Adobe Max conference, the company did release an update to Lightroom with a lot of really cool improvements and new features. And rather than create one long video covering everything, I'm going to just create separate videos for each of the major improvements and features. For this video, you might be familiar with something like this if you've ever used the portrait mode on your smartphone. So for example, with an iPhone, if you turn on the portrait mode and you take a photo of a person or an animal, and it simulates that shallow depth of field, we now have that functionality in Lightroom on the desktop and on mobile devices. So in this video, I'm going to show you what this new lens blur feature does and how it works on desktop, and then I'll switch over to the iPad and show it to you there. Now on the iPad, what I show you is exactly the same as the iPhone. So regardless of which device you have, you'll be able to use the feature the same way. So let's jump in. All right, so as I mentioned, this new feature is called Lens Blur. And if you go to the edit panel here and you scroll way down, under optics, you'll see a new section called Lens Blur. So here's the thing. The first thing that I recommend doing is expanding it, obviously, but also making sure that you expand these three disclosure triangles under blur amount, then under focal range, and visualize depth. And I'll go over each of these in a minute. Now, before I actually show you how this tool works, I want to call attention to this blue early access badge. And it's important because if you click it, this little dialog box pops up and it gives you a preview of what this does. But more importantly, I want to highlight that second point where it says lens blur works best with a clear subject, foreground, and background. And I think this is important. Again, this is early access, so it might not work perfectly and the results may not be amazing. But I'm glad that Adobe at least set expectations of the kinds of photos you should try to use this with. So again, a photo that has a clear subject, foreground, and background. Let's go ahead and click on Got It to dismiss this. Now, all you need to do to begin using Lens Blur is to click on the checkbox for Apply. And what will happen is Lightroom will use AI to identify the subject. So if you just want to see the effect in action in its simplest way, what you'll do is you'll take this blur amount slider and you'll drag it out. And I recommend just bringing it to 100. And so here you can see the mask that Lightroom automatically created. It identified me and it didn't just make a selection around me, but it created a really nice transition from the foreground to the background. Now, of course, this is way too strong of a blur amount. So I recommend just like with most of these effects, use it sparingly as far as the strength goes. But it is a great way to create more separation between your subject and the background. And then below that, you see there's a section called bokeh, and here's where you can choose the type or quality of the bokeh or aperture. So the first option is a circle option. The second is called bubble. The third is a five blade, simulating a five blade aperture. Then there's a hollow ring, and then finally cat eye. And so if you click on these and you look at the background, I'll zoom in over here, you can see how it kind of changes those specular highlights based on the option that I select. And it becomes more pronounced as you add more of that blur. So you can see here how it really becomes pronounced here. But that's just a way to visualize what this option does. And then there's a boost slider. And this basically, as you can see here, it adjusts the brightness of the out of focus light sources. So if I make it brighter or darker, you can kind of see in the background, especially right around here, how the brightness is adjusted. I don't particularly find that slider very useful, but you know, you might want to give it a shot when you're using this tool. Again, let's go ahead here and bring that amount back a little bit. Now let's talk about where the power of this tool comes in, and that is determining what should be in focus and what's out of focus. You have two ways to do that. The first is to use AI, and that is over here under focal range. This is the subject focus option. It's the same subject selection tool as you see in the masking mode when you go to masking and then you see select subject. The same basic thing. It's using AI to determine what the subject should be, and then that generates the mask for the out of focus areas. So if we go back here, you can see that we do have select subject, which is the default option. But then there's also this point area focus where you can manually choose what should be in focus. So let's say I select this and I actually want the background in focus. I can just create a selection like this And you can see how the mask is almost inverted. So now the background is in focus, but I'm out of focus. However, the effect is not always especially good because if I disable lens blur, I was never out of focus to begin with. There was sharp detail on me. So what's happening here is that Lightroom is applying a false blur or a fake blur to me, and it could be hit or miss. But the point here is you can change your plane of focus after the fact. But I'm going to stick with Lightroom's AI subject selection, so I'll click this again, and you can see that the mask is restored. Below that, you have a focal range graph. And the way this works is you can see from left to right, it's kind of like white slash yellow, and then it goes on to blue. Specifically, the yellow indicates things that are closest to you, and blue indicates things that are further away in the frame. So watch, let's say I take this range over here and I drag it to the right. Look at the image. As I do that, you see how I'm becoming out of focus, but the background's becoming in focus. So anything in this range here will be in focus, and anything outside of it will have that blur applied. So again, this is a different way to visualize depth. So here, by moving this focal range here in the yellow, which is what's closest in the frame, that's what's being kept sharp, whereas things that fall outside of it are out of focus. Now, of course, you can grab the bumpers on either side to make this even more refined. Like if you really want to dial in that range, you can, but you should be careful because it's easy to have parts of, say, your subject fall out of focus. For example, you can see here how the edge of my camera bag is out of focus, and even part of my face is out of focus. So just have to be careful there. Sometimes it's best just to have a little bit of a wider range over here. And again, if you want Lightroom to redetect, just click on this icon here again and it'll do another detection. Now let's talk about how we can visualize this depth. Yes, we do have this chart over here, but it may not be very helpful because it doesn't show you that information on the image. So to do that, you can click on visualize depth, and now you actually have this chart represented in the image. So again, I mentioned that yellow is areas that are closest to the camera, and blue are areas that are further away. So this is depth. Depth controls what's closest and what's further away. So there you go. Now you also have more granular control over saying what should be in focus and what should be blurred. And that's with these two brushes here. So it's kind of like a paint in and paint out. If you want areas to be more in focus, then you'll tap on focus over here and you'll see you now have these options in terms of a brush size, the feather, and the flow. You also have the option to use auto masking, which is kind of like a semi-intelligent brush mask. So it'll identify what should be brushed in and what shouldn't be based on high contrast edges. But let's say I want more of the foreground in focus. What I can do is I'll turn off auto mask here and I'll increase my brush size and I'll start painting. And you can see that, again, things that are being painted in yellow are being indicated as closer and should be in focus. And I just can make my selection as I see fit. Now, if you want to see that in action, you can disable the visualize depth and you'll see what this image looks like with the lens blur effect applied. But in this case, I do think it's helpful to have that visualize depth option enabled. And of course, if you want to remove areas or you want areas to be blurred, you can select the blur option here and do the exact same thing where you can paint and those areas will have blur applied. Again, if we disable the visualize depth, you can see that this area is now out of focus. The cool thing is you can have multiple brushes. So you can have a brush here that tells where you want things out of focus. And then you can click on this plus button here and then paint areas that you want in focus. So you don't have to just do one or the other. You can actually really refine exactly where you want things to be in focus and where you want things to be blurred. And then if you want to see the preview of what this effect is doing, you can press and hold on this eye icon here. So you can see this is the original photo where the entire foreground and background are sharp. And then this is what the lens blur effect does. Now I want to just get rid of those brush strokes that I made. So I can click on this icon here, which will reset that. And so we're now brought back to kind of a default state. All right, so that's pretty cool, right? Like it's super cool to have these additional functions in Lightroom to add creative effects to the photo. It's always great to have the ability to edit raw files and have a really good raw processor, but I love that Adobe is giving us more creative tools to further enhance the look of the photo. Now, before we jump over to how to use Lens Blur on the iPad, I just want to take a quick minute to tell you about my new course called Lightroom Everywhere. If this kind of stuff excites you and you are considering either starting to use Lightroom from scratch or you're a Lightroom Classic user who may want to move over, especially because Lightroom now has local browsing, you should definitely check out my course. Again, it's called Lightroom Everywhere. The link is in the description below. It's got over 40 videos and over 8 hours of easy paced lessons that will teach you absolutely everything you need to know about getting the most out of your Lightroom subscription. Again, the link is in the description below. Your purchase directly helps support my small business and it helps me continue making these videos for you. So with that, let's move on to the iPad. Okay, so here, this is a photo I took a few years ago in Morocco, and I want to use this photo because it'll illustrate actually how good Lightroom subject detection is, because we do have a clear subject, but the separation between the background and the foreground is not the easiest. Everything is pretty sharp from front to back. So let's see what Lens Blur can do. You can access Lens Blur by tapping on the teardrop looking icon on the top right toolbar. It's right over here. And this is how Lens Blur works. The first thing it's going to do is attempt a subject detection mask, which it does kind of in the background. And the first thing I recommend doing is just taking that blur amount and bringing it to 100, because this will illustrate what the subject mask looks like. And as you can see, it is especially good. Now, you might notice that there are differences or kind of a lack of tools that you have available on the desktop. Specifically, there are no focus or blur brushes that you can paint in or out where this lens blur effect should be applied. However, you do have some of the mask visualization tools. And so to access that, you'll tap on the mask button on the very top toolbar. It's next to the question icon. So I'll tap that here. And you have three different options. If you tap on the ellipse over here, you'll see there are three depth overlay options. There's in-focus overlay, which is the default. There's entire image overlay. And then there's non-focal range overlay. So let's start with in-focus overlay. Basically, this is pretty simple. Whatever is white will be in focus. And whatever is kind of that bluer shade will be out of focus. That's the depth map. Then let's change it to entire image overlay. So here, this is showing you what Lightroom thinks is closest to the photo and what's further away. Like I mentioned on the desktop, anything that has a yellow kind of orangey warm color, that is closest to the camera. And then as it goes to blue, that is further away. And then finally, you have the non-focal range overlay. So here, anything that has kind of that shade of red, that will be considered out of focus. That's where the blur effect will be most prominent. And so with those three masks out of the way, you can disable that by tapping on the mask icon again. Now let's talk about selections. This is pretty much the same as the desktop. If you tap on this icon over here, you see two options. You have subject and point. Subject is that same select subject option that you have in the masking tool. This is automatically detected by Lightroom. Then you have point. Now, unlike Lightroom, where you can draw, say, a marquee tool, here you have a picker. And so what you can do is you can move this around to what you want to be in focus. So you can see here, because I have the background in focus, basically Lightroom did a select subject mask and inverted it. And the easiest way to represent that is simply by moving this to the focus point here. And you can see that that mask is inverted again. And all you need to do now is tap on the check mark to commit that, and Lightroom will refine the mask for you. Now, in this case here, I actually think that the manual selection does a better job than the auto subject detection. And so I'm going to stick with that. And just like on the desktop, you have your five different aperture types. You've got the circle, you got bubble, you have five blade, ring, and cat eye. And again, that changes the quality of the out of focus bokeh area. And like I mentioned with the desktop, these kinds of effects are best served in very subtle ways. So I would now drop that blur amount down just so that the background looks like it's slightly out of focus and the subject can really pop. When you're finished with Lens Blur, all you need to do is tap on the blue done pill on the bottom right. Or if you want to abandon those changes, you can tap on cancel, but I'm going to go ahead and tap on done. And of course, if you want to refine this, just tap on the lens blur icon again, and you have all of your settings here, which is one of the things I love about Lightroom. So that's super cool, especially that we can do these kinds of things, not only on a desktop, but on our mobile devices. I really do love that Adobe is giving us not just better technical tools, but more creative tools that allow us to really enhance the look of our photos. Again, if you're looking to learn everything there is to know about Lightroom, please check out my new course, Lightroom Everywhere. The link is in the description below. And be sure to check out this playlist, which has a bunch of Lightroom mobile and Lightroom desktop videos to help you get the most out of your Lightroom subscription. Thanks a lot.